So who's this girl with you today?
Her name is Melissa.
Uh-huh. And who's she?
She is my new girlfriend because my friend hooked us both up.
Your friend hooked you up?
Yes.
With her?
Yes.
How long have you been dating her?
2 weeks so far.
2 weeks so far. And what have you guys done? How far have you gotten with her?
Not too far yet. It's been too early yet.
What do you mean? Oh. You kissed her?
No, we didn't kiss each other yet.
You haven't kissed each other?
No.
You haven't done anything yet?
No.
So why do I have a feeling that this story is made up too?
It's not made up.
It's not made up?
No.
So you've been dating someone 2 weeks and you've never kissed?
No.
How many dates have you gone on?
2 dates so far.
2 dates on?
Yes.
And you've never even tried to kiss her?
No.
Have you held her hand?
Here and there, but my hands always sweat.
So you can't hold her hand?
Right.
I don't know, Erik. I think you tend to make a lot of this
no,
up.
No, this is not made up. It's not made up.
So then why won't you kiss her?
Well, she looks a little shy when I want to kiss her.
Oh, you're such a liar.
Dude, I'm not a liar.
You're lying.
Dude, I'm not lying.
You are too.
No, I'm not.
Come on. Well, you know we're going to find out.
No, I'm not lying.
All right.
So, Erik, how'd you meet, I'm sorry, what's your name?
Melissa.
How'd you meet Melissa?
Through my friend Ralph.
And what did he say? When he called you, said, what did he say, have a date for you?
He said to me that I have a date for you.
And where'd you go on your date?
We went to a diner.
Where?
In Queens, called the Georgia Diner.
What'd she have?
I had bacon cheeseburger deluxe with french fries.
What'd she have?
Cheese fries.
Okay. And so what'd you do on your date?
We went to the diner, and that was our first date.
What'd you do? You just went to the diner, and that was it?
We went to meet each other and talk with each other.
Right.
And then after that, we left, and I went home, and she went wherever she went.
Did you guys kiss goodnight?
No, we didn't.
So, Erik, this isn't really your girlfriend. This is a very pretty girl that you went out with once to the diner 2 weeks ago.
And then we went to a bar.
When?
A few days after that.
She said she only went out with you once.
Twice.
That was like, well, we went to the bar and there was other people there.
Right,
so.
Right. But it wasn't a date. It was just everybody went to the bar.
Right.
Could you really classify this as your girlfriend?
Yeah, I can.
Can you?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Would you kiss him?
Would I kiss him?
Yeah. I'm not going to ask you to do it now, but if Howard in there said, would you kiss Erik, would you?
I don't know. Not that type of girl.
Exactly. Okay, I'll be back in a little bit.
So, Gary, what did you find out with Erik's
man? She's not his girlfriend. He went out on a date with her once 2 weeks ago. He never kissed her. I said to her, you're sort of cute. What do you need to... She was set up on a blind date. And I said, well, how was he described to you that you decided to go out with him? She said, well, they told me it was high-pitched Erik. And I said, are you a fan of the show? And she said she was, but she doesn't know who Erik is. And then I threw him out of the room, and I asked her a whole bunch of questions to see if they matched his answers, which they did. I asked him where they went, what they ate, I swear to God. And, they seemed to, I think that what happened was he really did take her out to the diner 2 weeks ago. Somebody told her they might have been a nice guy. She probably thinks he's okay. They haven't kissed. They haven't done anything. They went to a bar a couple of days later with a bunch of people. It wasn't a date. And I said, can you really classify this as your girlfriend? And he goes, yeah. And she says, yeah. Then I asked if they would kiss, if Howard asked them to kiss in there, and she's not going to kiss him.
Yeah.
Can you blame her?
High-pitched Erik is here, and he's wasting my time. We told him, don't come back until you have a girlfriend.
Yeah.
Because he said he had a girlfriend, he had a date, but he just brought in some girl that isn't his girlfriend.
Yeah, I walked past the door and I said, there's no way that girl is with Erik.
I don't know why he's wasting my time. You know what it is? Gary said something very profound. He said, high-pitched Erik, his drug is airtime.
Yes.
And he just wants to be on the air.
He will do anything.
Yeah, and this girl, there's no way she's high-pitched Eric's girlfriend, and that's
not it. Only that, Howard.
Yeah.
There's a third person in the green room.
Oh, yeah, there's another
probably
guy
your real boyfriend.
Right.
Yeah. Who's the guy there with you?
The boyfriend.
Is that your boyfriend? No, not you. The girl.
I know.
But Erik, I know you love being on the air, but don't come. You know what? You're going to ruin it for yourself. Come in when you have something good. This isn't your girlfriend.
It is my girlfriend.
We already interviewed her. Gary, what happened? Tell the story.
I asked them how they met. I threw Erik out of the room right away to see if they were lying.
Right.
And I'll give it to you very quickly. They went out once to a diner. He bought her some hamburgers. He brought her home. Nothing happened. Then he said they went out a second time, but really it was a bunch of friends met at a bar. He was one of the friends. She was one of the friends.
And what is your first name?
Melissa.
Melissa, you went out with him because you heard he was from the show.
Well, initially, yes.
Yeah. And you went out with him, and you never kissed him, and you're not his girlfriend, right?
No, I am his girlfriend.
Oh, okay.
D- don't have to kiss somebody just to be their girlfriend.
You've never kissed him and you're his girlfriend.
Well, it's a blooming relationship.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
How many people have you gone out on one date?
Erik, you know what? Reality is funny. You don't have to make up stuff. Your life is pathetic.
Howard, this is my girlfriend.
Yeah, I know. Okay. Whatever. It's not interesting.
She just wanted to be on the show. You'll never see her again after the day.
I will see her again.
She won't kiss you.
Yes, she will.
You know what this reminds me of, Howard? The early days of Fred the Elephant Boy.
Yeah.
All these people used to use him to get on the air.
Right.
Like, all these girls and people are using him to get on the air.
Yeah, I mean, it's sad. Why are you taking advantage of Erik?
I don't take advantage of people.
Yes, you do. Erik is not your boyfriend, admit it. He's not your boyfriend.
We're boyfriend and girlfriend.
Go ahead and kiss her then.
Yeah, why wouldn't she want to kiss you?
Right.
Look at her.
Because she's repulsed by you. Oh, look.
Yeah,
that's some kiss.
Oh, did you see her recoil?
I give more kissing to my grandmother than that.
You'd kiss him harder than that.
No. Howard, did you see that? He moved in and she moved back.
You're not attracted to him, are you?
No, I didn't.
You're not attracted to him, are you?
What do you think of me? Seriously.
I think he's cute.
You think he's cute?
Oh, please.
Yeah. No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, where do you go to school?
I'm out of school.
What do you do for a living?
What do I? I work for a financial firm.
You do?
Yes.
Yeah, and that's who you want, high-pitched Erik. Erik, this is pathetic.
Why?
Because I want to have you on the show and you have something legitimate going on. I'm not interested in this.
This is my real girlfriend, I'm telling you.
You're pathetic. This is sadder than anything I've ever seen.
This is my...
Like, you can't get a girl, and now you bring in some friend.
She's not a friend.
You're
she's
doing
not...
anything trying she... to get
Seriously,
her.
She's my girlfriend.
Yeah. And when do you plan on kissing her? She's your girlfriend. Usually your girlfriend will kiss you, and she's kind of excited to do it. Dude, this is pathetic.
Melissa, what are you getting besides airtime? What is he giving you?
You want to promote something, or is he paying you?
No, we went out and had a good time.
Yeah. What is it?
How did you meet?
I'm just so pissed off at Erik because he swore to me and Gary. We had him on the phone. He swore this was his girlfriend. I said, Erik, if you're lying, you're never on the show again.
He lies all the time.
And now he lies. But, I mean, even when we told him, if you're lying, you're never on the show ever again.
Right. I think we should ban him.
But he'd already
done
it.
He should be banned now.
Well, you guys hate high-pitched Erik.
No,
he calls 100 times a day. He faxes like you wouldn't believe. And he writes in this, like, scary retard scroll that you can barely read.
Right.
And he's always trying a different angle. Like, I'm worried about Big Black being dead. Always something like that. So we can get him on the air. And this time, and it's been plenty of times, this time I said, Erik, if you're lying, we're never having you on again. He goes, I'm not lying.
And his drug is airtime.
And here's what's going on, Howard. We've reduced his drug because now that you banned him from doing all those other wacky radio shows he used to do, this is the only show he can get on.
His only outlet.
And so he's got to get on the show a lot.
This is my real girlfriend.
So then make out with a tongue kiss.
Address one of those issues,
Erik. I told you this. Tongue kissing in.
Oh, here they
tongues,
go.
Tongues.
Oh, wait a second.
Oh, I do see something.
Oh, please. Oh, she'd do anything for airtime.
Oh, she is making
it. Maybe that is his girlfriend.
It is.
I told you I am.
You know what? I take it back. You're looking nauseous. You know that?
All right, go to second base right now.
We'll have full sex.
That kiss was a little nauseating, wasn't it?
Not at all.
There had to be some amount of money in that she needed because she did it.
Were you paid to be here today?
No, I make enough money.
Say, I swear, do you believe in Jesus Christ?
Yes, I do.
You do. Say, I swear to the Lord Jesus Christ, I was not paid to be here today.
I swear to the Lord Jesus Christ, I was not paid to be here today.
I swear to the Lord Jesus Christ, I am high-pitched Erik's girlfriend.
I swear to the Lord Jesus Christ that I am high-pitched Erik's girlfriend.
So you've had many relationships like this with people you don't kiss?
Some.
Hey, Erik, how was that kiss?
Oh, man, that was the best.
First ever.
Oh, it was really good. I hope you guys don't believe me some more.
And who else knows you two are a couple? Is it well known around town that you're a couple?
Our friends now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's call one.
Yeah. Give me a number and I'll call him. I mean, you know.
Ah, please. Who's it? What am I? The police?
No, but
who cares?
All right.
So you got a girlfriend. What do you want me to do?
I'm happy.
You are.
And by the way,
where did you two meet?
We met through a friend.
You know, he's in love with being on the radio. He just loves to get on the radio. You know that. That's his thing.
Well, what do you do when you leave here, Erik? Do you call all your friends and tell them you were on, or do you take your tapes and play them for people? Like, what's the gig?
Yeah. Like, what's the rush?
No, when I leave here, let's say I'm off from work, okay? Right. But when I leave here, after work, I tell people I was on the radio. They tape it for me because I'm not home to tape it.
Right.
And so they tape it for me. They give me a copy of it.
But is that fun?
Do you go to work and does everybody know that you're high-pitch Erik from the Howard Stern Show?
Everyone knows at work that I'm high-pitch Erik.
And does everyone high-five you on your appearance and stuff?
Sometimes.
So it's good to be. So you like being famous, is that it?
I like being famous also.
Right. Are you a virgin? I know what high-pitch Erik is. Are you?
What does my virginity have to do with?
Well, I'm just curious. Have you ever made love to a man?
Yes, I have.
Oh, you have?
Yes.
Huh. When will you do Erik?
When do you think you'll be interested in having sex with Erik?
time will tell. We'll see where it goes.
All right. Well, that's legitimate.
How many
legitimate.
Dates have they had?
One date. Right?
One,
right? One, yeah. Two.
We went on the one, and then the second one was with other people there. So.
Right.
Eric's hands are wet right now.
Have you ever felt Eric's hands? Look, they're all wet?
You see them? They're actually wet.
Yeah, I know. They drip.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? They're dripping wet.
Yeah, that feels good. Your hands are cold.
She's attracted to that, Howard.
Yeah.
Is that like the cold, clammy kind of guy.
Ow!
Yeah, what was it? She's a nice-looking girl.
She's very cute. What was it, Melissa? Was it the big ass or the high voice?
What got you?
Yeah, what got you first? What were you attracted to most?
He's got nice eyes.
He does?
Yeah.
Let me see your eyes.
Who can see him?
Yeah. Those are nice eyes?
They're baby blue eyes.
They're huge bags under them.
I'd like to see who she's rejected.
I can't believe she looks at him and the only thing she sees is eyes.
Yeah, well, that's what girls see with me, too. I know the feeling. I hate when girls go, you know what? You got nice hair and eyes. And I go, aye.
Yeah, you were hoping for like a nice chest.
Yeah, right.
Cute ass.
Yeah, something really hot. All right, high-pitched Eric. So you did it. You got on the show again.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not banning high-pitched Eric from the show. I like high-pitched Eric.
Well, she kissed him, so...
Yeah.
And by the way, if high-pitched David is listening to the show, I have a girlfriend, high-pitched David. And if you want to call and criticize me about not having a girlfriend, why don't you call up and I'll put you down?
All right, there's fighting words.
Ah, he's drawn a line in the sand. Yeah.
So this is it for you, huh? You got a girlfriend. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right.
How come you call her a girlfriend after one date? I don't understand this.
Want to answer that, Hyper Shark?
Hmm.
But you're feeling like your boyfriend and girlfriend.
I understand it.
Yeah.
When you've never had one, as soon as you get a girl, you call your girlfriend.
I guess after every date, it's a girlfriend.
You got a girlfriend.
But you feel like you're his girlfriend.
Yes.
Yes. And you're not seeing anyone else?
No.
And you're going to be exclusive to high-pitched Eric?
Yeah.
Really?
Till I get to the door.
Right. Yeah, when's your next date?
Like a rug.
When's your next date?
Maybe this weekend?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Where are you going to go?
Don't know yet. Only time will tell.
Too bad there isn't a place you can go where everybody has a high-pitched voice. And you'd have the deepest voice there. Do you like the sound of his voice? Do you find it sexy?
I think it's cute.
You do?
Yeah.
All right, good. Okay, well, there it is.
And you're in the financial... What do you do in the financial world?
Hello?
Well, I can't really say.
Yes?
I work... For consulting services.
Ma'am?
Hello?
Yes?
Is this Howard?
Yes.
Hi, Howard. Hey, I have a question I want to ask you.
All right.
It's about your movie. Remember that part in your movie where a girl had an orgasm on the radio?
Yes.
I was wondering if that was true.
Oh, yeah, ask Robin. We did that in Washington.
Oh, I just want...
Oh, Jesus. You could probably get a date with her, too.
Really? She sounds like she's lonely. No,
hi, you're
I just
on
wondered...
The...
Because yeah. Eric works in the mailroom. This girl sounds like she's got a pretty happening job.
Well, she says she's in the finance area. That could be she's the checkout girl at the supermarket.
But even so, I was saying to her, you know, I said, how'd you meet Eric? And she said, it was a friend of a friend, a blind date. And I said, well, you look pretty cute that you don't really need to go on blind dates.
Well, a lot of girls have trouble, right, Robin? Seriously.
It's you know, it's a possibility. Everybody does blind dates.
But could this girl have that much trouble that
but
she needs high-pitch Eric?
Eric on a blind date, what would you do?
Run.
I'd head for the hills.
Or if the friend that set you up on the blind date is a good friend, how on earth could they have described Eric to you? What would they have said? That would make
what did your friend say to make you want to date high-pitched Eric?
Want
to
have a goof?
No.
You got a few hours to kill?
No, she called me up and said that her friend had a friend who needed a date, and would I be interested in going? And I figured, why the hell not, you know?
And they said he was from the Howard Stern Show? You figured, hey, maybe this is...
Yeah, they said he was hyper jerk. So I said, how bad can it be?
Right. But
you
it was pretty
say,
bad.
You didn't say, what does he look like?
Well, I kind of asked, but I don't really care because, you know, I've been on a lot of dates, and some cute guys are real jerks, so...
Right. So you find hyper jerk to be sensitive.
Yes, it's okay. Very nice.
You're on the air. Hi. Nobody there. Tony, go ahead.
Howard.
Yep.
Why don't you get that scumbag off the air, man?
Who are you talking to?
Guy's a scumbag, man.
Hey, if anyone's a scumbag, you are.
Hey, listen, I'll come down there and punch your lights out, pal.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah.
You didn't know what I even look like, do you?
Huh? Yeah, a scumbag. Of course I know what you look like.
You're looking for a scumbag and I'll knock you out.
Hey, is scumbag your favorite word?
You can't bother me, pal. You're a scumbag. You know that.
Hey, I want to talk about you. Who's got the girl and who
doesn't?
See
you later. I'll wait for you downstairs.
Oh, you do that.
All right.
Howard.
Here's a high-pitched David.
Oh, please. Howard, I just got to ask you something. First of all, Howard.
Yeah.
Why are you so forgiving to this? The guy, the other caller was right. This guy's a scumbag. He's a jackass.
Well, what did
Erik,
he do wrong?
You are also a traitor.
What do you mean, high-pitched David?
Just call me HPD, okay?
High-pitched David.
To you.
High-pitched
Mr.
David.
Master HPD.
No, I'm gonna
I will take you and your high-pitched voice and your small little wiener that this girl seems to like. If she saw a real man, she wouldn't know what to do.
Oh, yeah, you never seen my wiener, have you?
Excuse me?
You never seen my wiener, have you?
You high-pitched, intellectually challenged, voice challenged.
All right.
Yeah, you want to meet me downstairs today? I'll meet you downstairs.
Well, what about the other guy? You don't want to go two against one, do you?
I'll go two against one.
You would. You've been in a lot of fights, right? You handle yourself.
Yeah, I can handle myself.
All right, Erik, you're on the air.
Hey, high pitch Erik. Hey, man, you sound like a retard.
Hey, I wouldn't talk if I were you. You sound like one also.
You sound like Mickey Mouse, man.
I wouldn't talk if I were you.
What do you mean? I wouldn't talk.
You ever try to lower your voice?
Is that your real voice?
No, you can't.
It's my real voice.
Oh, that's his real voice, all right.
Now, hey, what is...
Let me put you through this sound machine. Maybe it'll help you. Go ahead, do it.
It's my real voice.
Doesn't even help that.
What is that chick seeing you?
It's worse.
Yeah. What is that chick seeing you, anyway?
Well, she obviously thinks he's sensitive and likes him, and obviously she likes his fighting spirit.
Yeah, I was going to say, isn't this turning her off?
Yeah.
Does that voice turn her off in the sack or what?
Evidently not. So you guys haven't been in the sack
They
yet.
Haven't been in
no.
the sack.
No.
Does Erik stand a chance of getting in the sack with you?
Possibly.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. He's laughing. I'd like to film that. Michelle, go ahead.
Howard?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm a friend of Melissa's. Melissa, it's Michelle from work.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi.
There we go.
Well,
what's going on here?
What's up? Give us the lowdown.
I didn't know Melissa had a boyfriend.
She never talked about it.
Well, she's only been on one date.
No, but I don't know. I'm with John, Melissa. We're driving into work right now.
Oh, hi, guys.
Hi.
All right. So here you are. You're on the radio, and you're... do you have anything to say about this? They sound like they're laughing.
Yeah, this is the big goof.
She's been out.
No, it's not. I just...
Do you think she's lying? Do you think this is really her boyfriend?
I don't... Melissa, I think, is a very pretty girl. I don't think she'd go out with somebody that sounded like that.
Right.
I don't know, but I don't know what he looks like, but...
He looks like he sounds.
Oh!
Yeah. Right, Robin, is there anything attractive about High Pitcher?
I mean, he's a sweet guy.
Yeah.
But, you know, just on looks alone, right. You're passing.
Yeah. Yeah, he's no Jimmy Kahn.
From what I hear, neither is Jimmy Kahn.
Could be. Anyway, congratulations to High Pitched Erik. He appears to have a girlfriend. If he's lying, that's even more pathetic.
I'm not lying.
And
not lying.
Michelle, is it Michelle?
Melissa,
congratulations on being Mrs. High Pitched Erik.
Thank you.
My mother was supposed to call in today.
Yeah.
Why?
To wish me a happy birthday.
How old are you?
Birthday?
27.
Really?
I don't know where she is.
Doesn't he look older than me?
Yeah. I know. He looks real old.
Yeah.
And now I'm worried.
I'm 44. I look younger than you.
I don't know where she is.
You're always worried about people.
I am. I'm a very worried person.
You know, you should be. Anyway, congratulations to the two of you.
Thank you.
All right. I don't think your mother called in because she's on a plane to Greenland.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
So you guys are officially a couple, I guess. Mm-hmm. When's the next date?
Probably this weekend.
Yeah, probably this weekend?
What day?
What do you think you're going to do? Why don't you ask her out?
Well, would you like to go out with me on Friday or Saturday?
Friday's good.
Friday's good? Where would you like to go?
Wherever you want.
Okay.
No, you choose.
Okay.
I'll have to think about it.
Okay.
I got to tell you, I think you are very pretty. I think you're the nicest girl in the world. I think you're the world's worst actress. I think you're so sweet. I just can't believe that you're with Erik. I'm just not buying it. Just from having done this for a number of years, that just my vibe tells me that there's something going on here. But if you are a couple, I wish you the best of luck. I'll shake your hand. Yeah, I'll shake your elbow because you're all slimy. You guys, good luck. Have a great day.
Thank you.
All right, guys. Well, congratulations. And how soon do we think the breakup is going to come?
Be positive?
Yes. Be more positive, you're saying?
Yeah, be more positive. Who says that we're ever going to break up? You don't know.
All right. All right, you guys want to hug each other and say goodbye?
Well, it's up to her.
Well, you know, you guys finally kissed in there, I mean, for the first time. What was that like?
It was a nice kiss.
It was pretty good.
Pretty good?
No, seriously, it was awesome. It was a good feeling.
It was a good feeling?
Yeah.
Was there tongue or anything involved?
You want to answer it?
Yes.
He actually tried to slip the tongue in, or did you?
It was a mutual tongue.
Yes. Uh-huh. A mutual tongue kiss.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
All right. So do you hold his hand? I mean, now that we find out that his hands are real slimy and stuff, do you hold his hand at all?
I'll hold his hand.
You will. You're not afraid of the sliminess of his hand?
No.
No, not at all?
No.
Okay. All right. So, guys, congratulations.
Thank you.
And hopefully this will continue, and maybe you guys will have high-pitched kids.
Okay.
All right. So we'll see you guys.
Thank you.
All right, thanks.